So I've painted clouds onto the blue sky paint, and I've used spray cans. Could have used an airbrush, but spray cans did quite a neat job, I think. They look quite good. And I'm going to put the foam board in at some point and build up the mountains to about this height, so about halfway up. So actually the layout probably is about the right inches high, 24 inches. Now, I've got a little bit of help tonight. This is Pixel. He's decided to sit on there, haven't you? Come say hello to camera. Pixel's my tabby cat. He's the brother of Neon, aren't you? A little bit shy. And I've got the Junior Express train, Hornby Junior. It comes apart quite easily. There are just three screws underneath. Now this is the dummy car. Take the pantographs off, just get a screwdriver under there and lever them off. This is the fake switch on the power car. That is actually a functioning switch. This also I have to take apart at some point. There's an LED, interestingly, in here. It's not connected to anything. I could use that, and that lines up with a hole in the front there. So perhaps I might put that LED in there. I'm going to take all of this off. I've taken the bogies off as well. They simply prise off with a screwdriver. This is the part I'm interested in. Not much, really. But I think if I put something under there, I'll turn this into a monorail shape. And then I combine it with the rest. The total length of the train is quite long, actually, and it comes to about midway on the layout. So there we are. If you ignore Pixel for a moment. Lovely though you are, Mr. You can't stay there forever. The crash train is going to be about in the middle of the layout now, which wasn't originally where I was intending the ravine. I'll probably put it still a little bit over to the left. In fact, these are the bridge sections I'm going to have. And one of them's going to be smashed up. So they do actually occupy quite a length of the railway. So I may put the ravine more over here. Yeah, and sorry, Pixel. Over there a little. Okay. He's off. I may put the bridge more about there. Yeah, so the track isn't completely parallel to the back scene. Be coming over here a bit. Actually, I might do it more the other way, more like that, I think. Yeah. That gives me more operational room for the rescue craft, and also Thunderbird 1 needs to sit here. So, yeah, that gives us an idea of how everything will go. Thunderbird 1, which I guess will be about there. And Thunderbird 2 will be down here. She needs to be more in there. Yeah. So perhaps actually, so I have to go a little bit more like that. Yeah, we're getting there. Getting there. It's giving me an idea of how it is. It should look quite good, actually. This is an episode I'm reviewing called Brink of Disaster, which features a monorail train. I'm not going to copy it exactly. It's that sort of thing I want. And then Edge of Impact features the Red Arrow 3, or Red Arrow 1 and 2 actually. And Red Arrow 3 is the aircraft that's going to crash into my bridge and cause the problem. Therefore the monorail hangs off a smashed bridge. So that will get a couple of episodes, Edge of Impact and Brink of Disaster, sort of referenced within my model. Although not specifically. It'd be good for fans to see if they can recognise Red Arrow 3, and what episode it comes from, Edge of Impact. It's made from a Saab Draken. This is an Airfix model kit with an extension on the engine And the original was Hustler engine components here. I've used other components very similar. I'm going to have a section of board at the front in the end, so I've got a level here. And then there'll be a little bit of river here, and then some more board, which is land. And then the rest of it, which is this high, represents the mountains creating the mini ravine. Now, I'll put the locomotive up there. That's the length of the loco. And there's two pieces of bridge that are made up. Now, one of these is going to get smashed up because the plane will have hit it or hit near it and it will have crumpled and the train's hanging off it. So if it's that one that's smashed, the train will be part way along, maybe a little bit further along, yeah, to there. So now I've got the position of the bridge because I've got the length of the train which dictates that position. I can now figure out where I'm going to cut. I'm going to put the balls together and cut using the saw. Might do this in the garden, might do it in here, not sure yet. It's going to get messy.